They just started being born. A miracle happened.
All right.
They called them hybrids. Your kind. It's your job to live a full life. He's talking to this antler.
Deer boy.
Kid. Deer boy.
Yeah.
But some bad people are still out there, Gus. Name's Gus.
Yeah.
And if I hear a voice, I will run.
Okay. And so it's a bit on. Of like a coexist type of thing. You got the animal kids who are hated by the religious extremists who want to kill them. Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. Okay. And of course, it's anybody who is anti-hybrid is a bad, the bad person.
Guy. Yeah. The intolerant bad guys.
Which it plays into this whole propaganda of everything that we're seeing now that's starting to get weird. Which plays back to the days of Noah.
But as the days of Noah were, so shall also the coming of the Son of Man be.
Speaking about socializing, get these kids used to walking around with hybrid animals, Birdman and Deer Boy.
Yeah. You know, the message of this is going to say, hey, we're all different and special in our own way. So just accept everybody for how they are, or else you're a mean religious person.
And okay. Also get young people to really think about how cool it would be to have deer antlers and stuff.
You know, I say that. Yeah, right. Yeah, good point. You know, I say that in a mocking way because it's such a played storyline. I mean, yeah. It's just so, I was thinking about this the other day. I was having a conversation with somebody and, you know, I kind of mentioned like, oh, you know, like Christians aren't, I mean, they're not like, it's not that cool to be a Christian. Like, it's not fun necessarily. And this person was like, what are you talking about? The whole, you guys are like, you rule the world. You're the, you got, like, everybody, you're the norm. Like, everything is built for you. I'm like, what are you, when was the last time you saw a movie or a TV show or a book or anything where a Christian was a good guy? Literally never in mainstream media is a Christian a good guy in the story. They're always awful, hypocritical people, yada, yada, yada. The religious people are always the bad guy. What is this crazy doublespeak where you have been taught that, like, the world is Christian and you're such a rebel for not being Christian?
Yeah, it's kind of an old played out argument.
It's so played out. And that's kind of what I find with this thing, like, ooh, the special children, but the religious people don't like the special weird children. It's like, oh my gosh, okay, we get it. Every storyline is this exact thing is so tiresome.
Yeah, which is not surprising whatsoever. But a lot of times when people bring that up, they're railing against either 20th century evangelicalism, the political military.
You know, I think construct. They're railing against a construct in the media that, I mean, they're only ever told, if you never met a Christian, if you never knew a Christian in your real life. Now, I'm not saying all Christians are great. There's certainly some ones that I hope to never meet again. But I'm not saying that they're, you know, if you're a Christian, you're inherently a good person. I'm just saying, like, if you never met one. And you only knew about Christianity through the media, which nowadays is more common than ever before. You only get contact with, you know, truly just with Christian people through stories on television and the movies.
Yeah, well, I've always said.
Of course would be thinking that they're the worst people ever. And of course, it's by design. We know this.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I was going to say that it was either the 20th century evangelical military political construct or the Catholics.
Yes.
Which is kind of like the main thing. And for me, I've talked about this before, but before, like, all my upbringing, my idea of a Christian was mostly given to me from The Simpsons. And Ned Flanders. Yeah. Ned Flanders was kind of like my model of what a Christian looks like.
Totally. Totally.
So there, I mean, that to your point. Yeah. And also I thought, even in high school, I was like, oh yeah, Christians, those are the ones that stand on street corners and tell you you're going to hell. Yep. You know, like not really thinking any deeper about anything regarding that. And you know, I even experienced, it was in high school. I think I had a world religions class. in high school, my junior year or something. And that was when I first started to ask why everybody was hating Christians. Because I went to public school and I remember this because it was on my birthday and I had to go back to school on my birthday after swim practice. It was like 7 o'clock at night. Yeah, on my birthday, I get to go back to school for Christian guy talk. Yay, yeah. World religion class. So I get in there. And I remember there was like, we had like a Buddhist come in and a Hindu and all this stuff. And it was always, my teacher was always very like interactive and let them go on and on about their religion and all this stuff. With the Christian, the guy started off talking about how his friend died in a car accident and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. And then he started getting into, only Jesus and all this. And then my teacher stopped him. He's like, all right, that's enough.
And really?
And it was like, at the time I was like, oh, thank goodness, man, this thing has only gone like 45 minutes. We're not going to be here for 2 hours. I get to go home on my birthday.
Yeah.
But then in hindsight, I was like, why was the Christian guy the only one that was like stomped on by this teacher? It was really weird. And so little seeds like that started to percolate in my brain. And then I think I read, Mere Christianity by C.S. Lewis and all the little seeds leading up to age 24, I think, was totally. When I was baptized. So it is different. It is interesting that the cultural view of things is that, the Christians, they basically, everything is built for them.
it's just ridiculous. Yeah, and the ending, the way that this conversation ended was this person was like, and I'm like, it kind of dawned on him that like, I was a Christian. Of course, he knows this, but he just didn't think about it like beforehand.
Because right. You're so cool. People don't think of you as a Christian.
That's exactly what he said. He said, you're like the only cool Christian I know. And cool I'm like, Christian. Bro, I am the only Christian you know. Like 100% of the Christians you know are the only cool Christians you know. So that it was just like the crumbling. You could see the crumbling of this worldview of like, oh, Basil's the only cool. Wait a second. He's the only. Oh, my gosh. Oh, my gosh. Everything I know is crumbling around me. Like, dude, just meet some other Christians. They're not all great, but there's certainly more cool ones than just me.
Well, and then I think the proper context of the worldview of what fallen humanity is and understanding that really helped me understand like, oh, okay. It's not based on like your assessment of people and their morality on this kind of stuff. It shouldn't be based on, oh, because you believe this or because you believe that. Yeah. It's more like, hey, it's like an inherent condition in all of us.
Yeah.
That made way more sense to me as a worldview than, oh, you're a bad person because you're this religion and you're a good person because you're this religion.
Yeah, right.
It's like a really shallow way of thinking about people. So anyway. Well,
it's convenient.
It's convenient. It's and, biased.
Just to connect it with something someone said earlier regarding the homeschooling conversation, don't sacrifice your children to the god of convenience, which, of course, as Americans, we are sort of trained to do. And it's just convenient to think of people in one-dimensional terms based on the categories that they fit in, which nobody should do, including Christians. Mm-hmm. And with that, I think we should end this show.
Let's wrap it up.
Okay, folks, thanks for tuning in to this episode of Canary Cry News Talk. Make sure to turn on your notifications, press subscribe, follow us in multiple locations, because we are going to be back on Monday, June the 7th. So make sure to be back here on the 7th. And really, I'm telling you, if you're just watching on YouTube, you need to follow other places. At any moment, we could be getting these more strikes coming on stuff that we've done months ago because, I don't know, they're angry that we're right about everything or something. So there you go. Make sure to catch us back on Monday. And thank you, because we'll need some producers for Monday's show. Just like we had producers for this show, it's the only way that the show keeps going, folks. And I want to thank our producers of episode 346 of Canary Cry News Talk. And those people are Patreon account of the year, Mackle G, Bush Protector is Gen X, baby, Egorius, Arnold W, Cherie H, Debbie Dubs, Daniel from Down Under, Johnson and Sons, Bill L, Sir Casey the Shield Knight, Malik W, James H, Killer Whale Channel, Saul A, Ciara, Stefan or Stephen M, Scott K, Tristan H, Fact Checker Bot, Kimberly W, and of course, Paul Green for sponsoring some the artist, producer, contest, which gives some producership credits to producer Dove, producer Debbie, and again, producer Ciara, double producer. There we go. Thank you to our time stamper for last episode, Rachel C. And of course, for the jingle, Jack V, our crypto Chad. And to all of our artists as well, Ali Dove and Jay Vella. You guys are the best. But you can produce the show by heading over to patreon.com/CCNT, or even better, head on over to canarycryradio.com/support.
canarycryradio.com/support.
That's right. And make sure to thank a producer today. They're the reasons that you get the show. For today's show. And remember, you know, you can become a producer in any amount you like. Just think of what kind of value do you get out of the show? What would it be worth to you to keep the show going? Put your own number on it, a number that's important to you. Make it feel good and take some ownership of the show by becoming a producer. Now, you can become a producer in many ways, not just financially, but you can also create some art for the show or jingles or music, any of those creative endeavors you can apply to the show. Just take a show related theme and create something out of it. You can send that to canarycryradio@gmail.com if you like it easy, or canarycryradio@protonmail.com if you like to keep it secret. And also, let's see, how else can they become a producer? Those ways. Those are the ways. But you can also help out the show quite a bit by leaving ratings and reviews. Please do so. It's very fun. It gives Gonz and I all the warms and the fuzzies. We love reading what you guys have to say about the show. And it helps out those algorithms, which really, unfortunately, is just kind of the name of the game when it comes to trying to do a podcast. So please, it helps us out a ton. Leave a rating and review on Apple Podcasts. Or if nothing else, just tell somebody about the show. Share the show out on your social media. Press that share button. Retweet something. Whatever it takes. Just get the word out, man. It's just the way things work nowadays. I know, we don't like it either, but you can really help us out. We're good at interacting when people share the show, that kind of thing. So do it. You never know when you might be the one to wake someone up to the fact that the world is not at what it seems. And here's the thing. Y'all got friends and family who are starting to realize that the world is not what it seems. Just share a show directly to somebody personally you know. It's very important. We like to call it rattling cages. And if you have any, if you need any more instructions, here's what you do. You walk right up to him, grab him by the cage, and then you shake it.
The end of the world occurred pretty much as we had predicted.
I want to shake things up, stir up some controversy, rattle a few cages. Hey, stop that! Don't ever silence me! I'm the last angry man, a crusader for the little guy!
Leave the bird alone!
Never! Rattle a few cages!
The human race will have every opportunity to improve.
And if they don't?
Ask Noah.
That's right. Just ask Noah. Gonz, any last words?
Woe to you, scribes and Pharisees, hypocrites! For you shut the kingdom of heaven in people's faces, for you neither enter yourselves nor allow those who would enter to go in. That's Matthew 23:13. And I feel like that's speaking to Susan and her crew over at YouTube.
Susan, YouTube. Susan. Okay. All right, everybody. We'll make sure to tune back in on Monday the 7th. Probably a little bit earlier than we did today, but we can't wait to see you there, folks. All right. Thanks for listening to this episode of Canary Cry News Talk. Make sure to tune in next time. But until then, think outside the cage.
Faces.
Never go slim jail.
Bitch to live by.
I'm getting a very good feeling about vaccination right this moment.
Remember, reality is an illusion. The universe is a hologram. Buy gold. Bye. I want to shake things up. Shake.